I shall be a fugitive and a vagabond on the earth, and it will happen that anyone who finds me will kill me. The Lord said to him, therefore, whoever kills Cain, vengeance shall be taken on him sevenfold. And the Lord set a mark on Cain, lest anyone finding him should what? Then Cain went out from the presence of the Lord and dwelt in the land of Nod on the east of Eden. And Cain got a wife, had children, and Cain started a city. You ever wonder where Cain got his wife from? How many times have you heard that question? Where did Cain get his wife from? Where did Cain get his wife from? Somebody from his family. But what you need to realize is the gene pool back then was pure.
Amen.
Right? So there wasn't a problem there. That was part of God's plan. The gene pool today is very bad, and this is why you have God's laws that state that kind of thing is wrong and forbidden. Okay? But what you need to understand as you move forward with the story about Cain is that his line and his children were those who were against God. They had joined the forces of Satan and his army. Seth and his line stayed faithful to God, and God continued to bless that line. But you come all the way down to the days of Noah. Have you ever traced Noah's lineage? Who did he come from? Cain's side of the family? Or Seth's side of the family?
Seth.
So you understand that Seth's side of the family were the children of God. Cain's side of the family were the children of man. Okay? So, as you look at this ongoing conflict, and you see where we're at today, and you realize that time is growing short, that Jesus is going to come back, the question you have to ask yourself is, what side of the family tree are you on? Will you be on Seth's side? Will you be children of God? Or will it be found that you're part of the children of men? The one thing that separates those two families is the cross and Jesus Christ. Amen. Keep your eyes focused on Him and your faith in Him, and you will be a child of God.
Amen.
Our closing hymn today is hymn number 526.
Thank you.
opportunity to worship you, to open your word, to see how you have worked from the beginning of creation and how you will work all the way to the last day. Father, I pray that you help each of us to realize our part in this great controversy, our part in your plan of salvation. Father, I pray that you will change us, that you will strengthen us, and that you will mold us into the character of your Son. For this we ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.